But yeah, let's hop into our favorite, or my favorite. I put the list together, but it's in no order specifically. We're not like with Eric Church, we put together two separate lists and then did our top 10. But this, we're just going in order by discography of songs that are on each album that you should listen to. So, first up is from his Who Needs Pictures album, which had, looks like, two number one hits on it, which were He Didn't Have to Be and We Danced. The other singles were Me Neither and Who Needs Pictures. But the not single that you should be listening to off of it is Holding On to You.
Oh, but every now and then I nod, and I pretend to pay attention, and I say things like, yeah, you're right, and are you kidding? And I laugh when it seems like the right thing to do. It's hard to hold a conversation, holding on to you.
I love this one because it's one of those where it's like he's going out on a date, but it's obviously too soon. Because it's just like, because the line in the chorus is, it's hard to hold a conversation when I'm holding on to you. And it's, so it's just like this really cool thing. And it's just like about how like, oh, she's, you know, telling stories and stuff. And I just kind of nod along like, oh, yeah, like just trying to pretend, trying to move on, but just it struggling to do so. And it's just a really cool kind of story in that sense.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, OG Paisley has a really great sound. I'm a huge fan of just the general aesthetic on his older albums.
Yeah. So I don't have to keep going back and forth from the video of you. I'm just trying to hold it up on my iPad. My iPad! Brad Paisley discography. Boom, America. But yeah, I don't know if you had anything else to add to that one, that song.
It is a song, and it includes music.
Yeah. But yeah, that's the only one really from the first album that I think is like super noteworthy. But after that is from...
Is I've Been Better on Who Needs Pictures, or is it on part two?
I've Been Better. That's on... I think it might be Who Needs Pictures.
Because that is one of my favorite Paisley songs, so that's, I would say, honorable mention to this list, because it's the classic type of song that I love, where it's, he feels miserable even though things are going good, and so he's, like, talks about how he, like, he got, since they broke up, he got a new job, and he's, like, out in San Diego on the ocean, and everything's great, but he's actually like, well, I've been better. So
yeah,
I love that one.
In a couple songs, we could definitely talk about that one, because there's a song that's similar to it that's on this list.
But, you're a song.
I know.
Baby, you a song. You make me want to roll my windows down and kill myself.
All right, cool. anyway, next up is from part two, which had two, or just one number one hit, which was I'm Gonna Miss Her, aka the Fishing Song. Also, Two People Fell in Love, Wrapped Around, and I Wish You'd Stay were all singles from it. But the non-singles you should listen to, first up is part two.
It wouldn't be that long till I'd see you in part two. We'd pick up where we left off when I lost you, and we'd fall in love again and change the way the story ends. We'd bring back me and you in part.
Love this song.
Yeah, this is obviously the titular song, but it's just a song. It's really cool about like breaking up. It's just like, yeah, but movies end, but then they bring it back for a sequel. So why can't we be like that? Where it's like, even though we've ended, if it was so successful like we think it was, they'll bring it back for a second time. And so
yeah,
like,
and he's like, there's gonna be something, you know, something clever that, you know, that they'll figure out a way to make it work out again. You know, it's,
yeah,
there's a chance. And nope, sad death.
Yeah, and it's like we said, I can't remember when, what episode, however long ago it was, when you said, you summed it up perfectly, where you're like, a Paisley song, a good Paisley album or song was like a Pixar movie, where it's funny in the right ways, but it's,
yes,
also like, it's also like a family friendly type happy song. Like, he has that, yeah, it's like a Pixar, he knows how to touch,
yeah,
on like the, you know, how to tug at your heartstrings, but he also knows how to make you,
yeah,
laugh.
How to do it in a non-hokey way, but also not, but also make it very accessible for like all,
yeah,
people.
Yeah, yeah. So I feel that part too, because it's a very clever way of talking about a breakup where you're comparing it to a movie like franchise type thing, and yeah, it's
yes,
it's
for
it's
sure. Love this song.
Yeah. Next up from the same album is the album. The song Come On
the
Over.
Whole album.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, I love this song.
Come On Over Tonight.
Come on over tonight. We'll sit on the swing. Watch the pigs fly by. Flapping their brand new wings. Just sit back and relax. Watch me eat my hat. While the oak trees sprout dollar bills. And I look you in the eye. Say the words I swore I'd never say in my whole life. So come on over tonight.
Yes,
but,
love this,
yeah,
song.
Yeah, I love it, where it's one of those where it's like you're the cowboy rambler type guy who would never think you'd ever say the words I love you to someone. Like, that would never happen. But then,
yeah,
he meets the person and he's just like, come on over, like get struck by lightning twice. We're gonna watch the pigs fly and all that. Like, it's,
yeah,
just this,
the things, all the cliche words that you would say, like, you know, like when
that'll
pigs fly,
happen,
when hell,
yeah,
freezes over, all that shit. You know, because I love the like the very first line of that chorus is just like, "Come on over tonight and watch me eat my hat." It's just like,
yeah,
<that's funny.
laughs> yeah, yeah. It's a fantastic song. This was always one of my favorites when I first started listening to country music, because it's the very simple kind of like acoustic background that's to it. I mean, obviously there's other instruments, but I always like the instrumental sound of this one.
Yeah.
But yeah. Next up is, God damn it. There we go. Is actually from Mud on the Tires, moving on to his third album, which had one number one hit, which was Mud on the Tires. It also had Whiskey Lullaby, Little Moments, and Celebrity, which were all obviously.
Yeah.
Even though somehow Whiskey Lullaby went 2x platinum but peaked at 3. What the fuck?
Yeah, that's nonsense, because Whiskey Lullaby is a just straight up stone cold like masterpiece of a song. So,
oh, yeah. Yeah,
anyone who doesn't think that it's incredible, you can go fuck yourself.
Exactly. But the next one is the first song that we have on here that wasn't written by him. It was written by Jerry Salley and Chris Stapleton, actually.
Stapleton's never written anything good, so I'm sure this song sucks.
Exactly. It's the best thing I had going.
My good friends come around to hang out now and then, and they joke, man, you sure got it hard with this house on the hill and a white picket fence, and the grass sure is green in the yard. But what good is all that knowing? The best thing that I had going is gone.
So this is the one that I was going to say, like, it's kind of like I've Been Better, because it's the song about a guy who gets a good job, he gets a good house, he gets all this stuff, he's working hard for his wife, but then he realizes that what he was working for left him. So, like,
yep,
he put
absolutely
all his time into working for the girl, but the girl ended up leaving him anyway.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because he spent
I would,
all the time.
Yeah, I would say, but, you know, part of the other reason why I've Been Better always sticks in my brain is because of my unabashed love for Jimmy Buffett-style music, and I've Been Better's,
yeah, yeah,
got a little bit of a Beachy Island thing going on,
yeah,
and I'm just like,
does,
yep, that's my shit.
Yeah.
Which is, you know what's hilarious? Not to go on a complete random side tangent. I love beach music. I hate beaches.
And you hate bitches, Mitchell Tenpenny.
Yeah, I ain't bitching with bitches, no bitch. Bitch.
No, it was funny. We were talking
about... But seriously,
about,
I hate beaches. Sand sucks. Man, I fucking hate it.
Yeah, I remember when we... I was talking to Megan at some point about how we would go out on Jake's boat and, you know, sit on the beach and drink and whatnot, and she's just like, yeah, but I hate the beach. I'm like, yeah, so do I, but I like being in the sun and drinking beer, so
yes,
I enjoy that part of it. But, yeah, no, I completely agree. I'm not a beach person. I don't like sand up my crack.
Yeah, it's just the most uncomfortable thing. It's fucking everywhere. Not my thing. I like to listen to songs about beaches while I am firmly planted here in the middle of landlocked Iowa.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, next up is another song written by Paisley. Back to one by him. It's the Cigar Song.
Well, I'm a sucker for fine Cuban cigars. The problem is I can't afford them. But last year I went and got myself a whole box. And just to be safe, I insured them. I took out a policy against fire and theft. And then I hurried on home. And with a 50-cent lighter, I sat on my back steps and I smoked them. One by one.
I absolutely love this song too. It's clever. It sounds good. It's a bit of a jam, but it's one of those classic storytelling country songs, like those kind of songs. Everybody loves. Like if you love country music, you love a good storytelling song, and this one's great.
And this is one where it's not like this super serious story. So it's like a really funny story that he wrote where it's a guy who buys a big thing of Cuban cigars, but then he, you know, he smokes them all and he's like, well, I want more, but I don't want to buy them. So he, you know, he insured them. So he's like, they went up in flames. They got destroyed in a fire. So he, so insurance covers it for another one and he does it again. But then later a cop shows up and it's like, well, now you're being arrested for arson. It's just like,
yeah, he's like for 24 separate counts of arson or 48 yeah. separate counts of arson.
Yeah. Even though I was thinking about that, I was like, how could the company sue him for arson? Wouldn't he just get arrested for arson? Cause it's his property.
He wouldn't get arrested for arson. He would get arrested for insurance fraud.
That's true. Yeah. Think of your lyrics
but
better,
that's,
Paisley.
Yeah, but that's that makes this makes the song so much less funny and fun.
Yeah, exactly.
He's like, and then I got arrested for insurance fraud.
Yeah.
End of song.
And it's just like this really serious story, like a you know, learn your lesson, kids type song. But yeah, no, yeah, it's a really fun song. I love it for that. Next up is, I think it's from the same album. It's a song written by Hank Cochran, Dean Dillon, and Vern Gosden. It was also a single by Vern Gosden. I didn't know that, so he covered it. Is It Raining at Your House?
Does it thunder?
But I just...
As Brad Paisley also said, me neither.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't know this wasn't a single by Vern Gosden. I figured... Because Paisley writes a lot of his songs, so it was when I was looking at them later that I was like, oh, I didn't realize this was a single. Because I only know Chiseled in Stone by Vern Gosden. I don't know him that well.
What about Set Him Up, Joe?
Oh, duh, obviously. I just heard so many covers of that song that I forget it's even his.
Like, yeah, it's also true.
But, yeah, he... So it's a cover of that, but I love the song because it's like this song of, obviously post breakup, you're like, it's pouring over at my house. It's, you know, going to shit. So he's like, is it raining at your house too? Or are you just kind of done with me type thing?
Yeah.
And I just really love it.
Yeah. The use of the raining imagery, you know, which is always nice.
Yeah. Moving on to his next album is Time Well Wasted, which had three number one hits on it, where it's Where and I Get Where I'm Going, The World, She's Everything. It also had the single Alcohol, which peaked at number four. So obviously this was a big hits album.
yeah, damn.
But yeah, so the first song off of this one I wanted to talk about was Out in the Parking Lot.
You can hear the band playing right through the walls. Ain't no cover charge, ain't no last call out in the parking lot. Yeah, I love to see the neon dancing on the gravel, and I love to hear the pickup trucks as they come unravel. Some have given up, some have given in. Seems like everybody's looking for a friend out in the parking lot.
This song is actually written by Guy Clark and released by Guy Clark from, it was on one of his albums shortly before this one came out. And it was also written by Daryl Scott. I don't know if I said that. But I just love this one because not only is it Paisley, it's Alan Jackson on top of it. And
yeah.
can't really go wrong with that combo. I mean, I'm not going to, you know, put down Guy Clark, but this is the version that I love of this song.
Yeah, no, this it's perfect. That, you know, mid-2000s, 2010s era country. Just perfect with Paisley and Alan Jackson. They do a really good job with it. Absolutely.
Yeah, and it's just the song itself is that story about, like, what happens out in, like, the you know, parking lot of a bar. It's just, like, people are out there fighting. The drummer's trying to leave, but the girlfriend's, you know, tugging on his sleeve. And these two guys were fighting, but then they threw up. And, like, it's just, like, this just funny story. And it's, like, you can hear the band from the parking lot, so you don't actually have to go inside and all that. It's just a really cool, good country kind of set the scene type song. And, yeah, I love it. Another song off this album that I love is Love Is Never Ending.
When the lights have all gone down, it'll still be hanging around. Even when you think it's lost, it can still be found. When every memory has been made, and the pages start to fade, and every prayer you ever prayed is heaven bound. When you think the ride is over, you're back at the beginning. Is never ending.
This is another one that actually wasn't written by him. It was written by John Goodwin and Bobby Terry, but I love it. We might have had it on the Country Love Song episode. I'm not 100% sure, but the song itself is just like, it's kind of like the, you know, George Strait,
Forever and Ever, Amen.
Well, it's that, but the George Strait one, I can't think of it, where he speaks grammatically incorrectly. Why can't I think what that song's called?
It just comes natural?
Just comes natural, yeah. So it's like the sun shines, clouds rain type thing, where it's like that, but it's all this happens, but love is never ending. Like, things come and go, but love is never ending. And it's just a really good love song, and I like it. Finally, with the final album that we're doing of this one is from his 2007 album Fifth Gear, which actually every single from this album went number one, including Ticks, Online, Letter to Me, I'm Still a Guy, and Waiting on a Woman, which are all fantastic fucking songs. And if you know me, you know that my favorite song of all time is Letter to Me. I love that song with a passion. It is a fantastic, fantastic song. So obviously I couldn't put that on the list because it is a single. But what I can put on the album, or the list, or whatever, is the first track off the album.
You can put it on the album?
Yes. I have the power to change his 12-year-old album. but the first song
by adding a song to it that is already on it.
Exactly. The first track off the album is All I Wanted Was a Car.
My buddy Blake was all state with dreams of the NFL. Jenny McClain had big brains. She got a scholarship to Yale. And there was Herschel, put it to commercials, and he was gonna be a movie star. But all I wanted was a car. Time job making chicken kebabs.
I just love this song because it's like the my friends are all working towards these goals, but all I wanted was a car. I was working all these jobs, I was doing everything to save up for the car, and that's all I wanted in life was to get a car.
Yeah, it's a great, you know, it's a great super relatable idea for like any teenage dude. I would assume girls also like cars and would want one in high school. But the over just obsessiveness with like all you want, like all you'd work your ass off just to have a car, even if even if the car's not going to be that great or anything,
it's going to be some crappy like $600 car. Like,
all you want is a fucking car because it equals freedom. That's the deal.
Yeah,
car exactly. Equals freedom equals awesome. And no I do love it.
Yeah,
and it's a good song. I like it for sure.
Well, I also love it because then it sums up in the end where it's just like, looking out in the driveway now, I got a minivan and a sedan, but I picked up your mom in that car. Like, it was such a...
Yeah, where he makes it all come full circle, because Paisley does a lot of that that's really well done, where he's like, starts out with the car, and then it ends up being that he uses the car to find the girl that he ends up marrying, and then when he looks back on it, he's like, all I wanted was a car. Look at how great my life is. It's like, fuck you, man. We can't all be happy.
Yeah. We can't all be a multi-millionaire guitar player. but
he is so good at guitar.
Oh, my God. It's unbelievable. Yeah.
So good.
Next up, moving on to another song off this album is Some Mistakes.
It could have been the moonlight. Could have been the wine, but the way that we were acting, hell, it could have been moonshine. And oh, where do we go from here? I don't know, but maybe one thing's clear. Some mistakes are too
some mistakes are worth making more than once. Like, sometimes I can't remember if this is a card where, yeah, this is the one where he talks about, I always fly down that road, but it's a speed trap, and twice I've gotten caught on it, but like, it's so much fun that I do it again. And so it's the same thing of like, hey, you girl, me, let's do this, because hey, it's a mistake, but hey, it's a fun mistake. So
exactly, it's gonna be worth it.
Yeah, and like, looking at these, I mean, obviously we do a lot of the sad, depressing songs that he does, especially in the later albums, which we'll do in the next episode. But he has so many just awesome, upbeat, great storytelling songs, and that's what I've always loved about Paisley, is that. And I mean, we'll get to it when we do the later albums, but I feel like he's kind of lost that in recent albums. Like, he just doesn't have that same feeling.
It's almost like, to me, that some of his newer songs where he's attempted to recreate some of the magic from the old albums, it seems like he's trying way too hard, you know?
Yeah.
The perfect analogy is like, he seems like he goes on these fucking Nationwide commercials and thinks that's like funny and like super relatable, and everyone's like, oh, Brad, you're so funny. But in reality, we're like, dude.
Yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, it's a bummer because, like, if you know me, I have fucking a forearm tattoo of, like, the actual physical Paisley, like, the design, and it's...
Which was named after Brad Paisley.
Exactly. And it's because, without Paisley, I would have never picked up a guitar to play. Like, the first time, it was hearing Whiskey Lullaby and Letter to Me, which were two songs that really got me to want to play guitar. And so, stuff like that. Like, I love Paisley for that. But, yeah, even though I'm a huge fan, I love his first, you know, 5-6 albums. It's just, in recent years, it's just like, I forget sometimes that some of these songs are out. Like, it's just like,
yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's... not a great album.
But, and how do you feel knowing that you have commemorated forever the guy who gave us Accidental Racist?
Hey, spoilers, that's on the next episode.
Deep cuts, the best song, Accidental Racist.
Part 3, Accidental Racist. It's just an hour of us talking about that.
Yeah, let's just do an entire episode about how great Accidental Racist is. And how, in fact, he actually did fix racism by himself.
That is true.
With LL Cool J. Well,
Cool J stuff. But anyway, the last song from Fifth Gear that I love that I wanted to talk about was With You, Without You. And I know you want me to move on. Start living a new life, start writing a new song. But don't worry, I ain't gonna ask you to come back and love me. Maybe you don't have to, 'cause I can be in love with you without you. This is obviously one of the biggest heartbreak songs of his that I love. It's just the whole thing of, like, I don't need you in my life to love you. I can love you even if you're not here. Like, you're telling me to move on, write a new song and all this, but I can love you with, or I can be in love with you without you. Like, and it's just like this, like, she's moved on, but it's like, I refuse to. I don't need you in my life for me to be a, still in love with you.
Yeah, the, yeah, the presence, the physical presence, doesn't change, you know, the or lack of presence, I guess, doesn't change how he feels, which is,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, it's a fantastic song. But yeah, so that's, I think, 11 songs from his first few albums that I wanted to talk about. Yeah, we'll do his later albums either next week or in a few weeks or whenever. We'll figure it out. I don't know. But
something like that.
But yeah,
So, no, this is a solid, doing this, especially beginning to break it up a little bit, that's nice to be able to, you know, talk about the older ones, because that, you know, really, as much shit as I give Brad Paisley about his later stuff, I really forget how great his older albums are. Like,
oh, yeah.
I really think that his first several albums, almost all the way through, I would say probably through Fifth Gear, are either mostly or entirely great, you know.
Yeah.
Like the albums are just they're top notch. His guitar playing ability is obviously incredible, and he shows it off in a great way on every album. And he was just stone cold country at the beginning, and so it's just it's a little disappointing that he has strayed away. But at the same time, he's given us such a huge volume of good songs. You can't totally hate on him. It's like, okay, I mean, he's recorded so much music that is good that he could just try to keep doing that, but then you'd probably shit on him for being repetitive. So I don't totally blame him for wanting to shake it up, except for the fact that some of the things that he's done to shake it up are bad.
Yeah, exactly.